Welcome everybody to the Untitled Wrestling Podcast. I'm at it. Try not to laugh. Number two. Can it be as good as number one? Probably not. I don't know what clips we're going to have, but let's find out, I suppose. Instantly got Dragon Ball Z on my screen. I don't know how this makes sense, but it does. Welcome to another Dowley Try Not To Laugh Challenge. Whilst it's bursting out fucking pot of the Asian. Yeah, one of them.
That wasn't funny, man.
Let's get started.
Oh, the scream. Whoa! The scream.
Oh, man, what you doing, Oz? Sweet beats, brother. We're back together.
Green Bay before.
What's that?
Beats, brother. We're back together again.
Noe Green Bay.
Is that random? Hey, get out, you bum battling.
He is paid for it.
Oh, this fucking bin shot. Oh, what's gonna happen to Goldberg? I feel like I should. Oh, yeah, he falls. There we go. Ah, serves you right. Fun fact, we met 2020, literally last year, 2022. She's up her own arse a little bit.
Kozlov all tied up here. How intimidating.
Check it out.
A classic.
Hey. That's when I first won the WWF. Oh, this is cool. That's us. We're going to be together. Oh, this is so cool. See you up there later tonight, okay? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Where?
What? It's for charity.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Who's in there, Kabuki? Oh, my God.
Genuinely, it's one of the best rivalries. Oh, in such a shit era of WWE, it's one of the best rivalries. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Are we getting it this time? There wasn't in the first one. No.
Okay,
Sean overdoing it because Hulk Hogan's up. And.
Even know if that's PG.
I thought you were gonna come out to, hey, good to see you, man. Hey, you like my belt or something like that. So I must agree. 15,000 of The Rock's hometown fans calling you are an asshole.
Asshole.
A long time ago, remember meeting your daddy, Cowboy Bob Orton? Yeah, with the cast on his hand. I remember that. And I also remember some cat named Soul Man Rocky Johnson whooping your daddy's ass.
Ooh, my dad beat your dad up. Ooh. It's one of those fucking playground things, isn't it?
Like, oh, I'll batter you.
Well, if you batter me, I'll get my uncle on you.
When you were like 5-6 year old.
And it just doesn't matter what type of match it is. It could be The Rock and Triple H in a no DQ match. It could be The Rock and DX in a handicap match. It could be The Rock and Stephanie in a stick 50 balloons right up your match.
The Rock wants anybody.
Why would you stick balloons up your ass? For what reason would you stick 50 balloons? And here's the next question. Are the balloons blown up? Are they not blown up? Are they water balloons? Are they air balloons? Some of the things you've got to ask, eh?
Your granddaddy, Bob Orton Sr., the Ross granddaddy, Hi Chief Peter Maivia, laying the
Samoan
Smackdown on his monkey.
Literally, oh.
I'll butter your granddad now.
What does that sign say? Today's my birthday, pin me Randy, you dirty fucking devil.
Now before you two jabronis start playing Ali and Frazier, and the referee being played by that prostitute in training.
What?
You can't say that.
But the one thing we agree on, the one thing we've always agreed on, is the fact that we know, Triple H, you're the biggest asshole walking God's green earth.
That wasn't a very good one.
Way back more than that. Your big fat ass grandmammy, your mammy, they all plane. Hell, The Rock's grandmama, his mama right there, slapped the lips off all two of them bitches. I remember looking at you, sitting there picking your nose, wiping it on your shirt. Eddie Guerrero, you
I have nothing
movie
to say
star.
Anymore about that.
There's something up with The Rock. Who are you? Were you Cheech or Chong?
Come on, Guerrero, they're out of control right now.
Why are we on The Rock all of a sudden?
They're going to get their monkey asses whooped tonight. The Rock's ribs, The Rock's ass. The Rock's got hurt ribs, big deal. It's no big deal at all. The Rock says this, you go ahead and take out The Rock's ribs, fine. Take off one of The Rock's arms, he'll fight you with the other arm. You take off one of The Rock's legs, The Rock will hobble and hobble and hobble and keep hobbling and whoop the monkey ass with the other leg. Easy, big fella, easy.
Well, it was to be a star early, like in the late 90s, would just make up some nonsense, make sure it makes sort of sense, and you'll get away with it. If you do it in a funny voice, it's funny. That's what it seems to be with The Rock, especially in the past six clips or whatever. Can we not have The Rock now, please?
Oh yeah, you go ahead and you can take off one of The Rock's testicles, the people's testicles. Oh yeah, The Rock will take the other one, throw it way up in the air, keep watching it. Damn, that's a good ass testicle. The Rock will take his boot, shine it up real nice. Excuse The Rock.
He just ate his own testicle.
Stick it straight up Benoit Guerrero's tiny asses. It's an after the show. Yeah. Is that what you're gonna do? Huh?
We're still on the road.
With a haircut like that and a face like that, it looks like Billy Ray Cyrus went ahead and had sex with a retarded hyena.
Oh, can you throw that word out? Can you throw that word out these days? I didn't even listen. I just heard the word. Come on.
Huh? All right. Shut up! It is. With a haircut like that and a face like that, it looks like Billy Ray Cyrus went ahead and had sex with a retarded hyena.
As opposed to a normal one?
Come on, Rock. Oh, shut your mouth. I went to shake your hand. Hey, man, how you doing? You're like, oh, no, this is my pretty pony. Don't touch my pretty pony. Remember that?
I don't remember.
Shut your mouth. And then you just ran. You ran. You ran right by Andre the Giant, right by Junkyard Dog, smack dab right in the middle of King Kong Bundy's ball sack. No!
He talks a lot of ball sacks and testes. Is that his thing? I feel like 2000... I didn't really care for The Rock in 2003. Did anyone care for The Rock in 2003? No. Shit one to say, but no.
Play that Barry Manilow music.
Yeah.
What the fuck is that?
Charleston, turn the other way. Yeah, turn the other way. Face the camera. Yeah, smile at everybody at home. Bend over. Get your money.
Too late. He looks like he's enjoying himself.
Doesn't speak Spanish all that well, but let The Rock tell you in a way that maybe you'll understand. It goes like this. Eddie Guerrero.
Uh-oh.
You want a shot at the great one, but there's only one problem, is you never told him whether you were Cheech or whether you were Chong. Ayariba, ayariba.
That's so shit. Oh. At least if you're going to be somewhat a bad person, at least make it a good joke, like.
He continually gets disrespected.
Oh yeah, whoa, no, The Rock ain't done. The Rock got some more. It goes like this.
Guerrero, you're still
and
going.
The Rock in this ring will meet, and when it's all over, The Rock whooping ass on Latino heat. Ayariba, ayariba.
Ayariba, ayariba.
Chris Jericho, you are still the undisputed champion, and Chris Jericho,
really,
you are still the biggest monkey's anus walking God's green earth. Laughing, I was like, no, hold on, we're not done. I was laughing my ass off. And you were sitting there, and your dad was like, hey, Dwayne, don't laugh. One day my son's going to be great. I looked up at Jed, I said, no, Mr. Orton. I called him Mr. Orton because I respect him. Mr. Orton, actually, one day, I'm going to whip your son's candy ass.
Yeah.
Well, The Rock says this, Big Show, you come on down. You do all that all you want, Undertaker. You come on down. Die. And all that stupid crap.
No,
over and over
is this
and over
the
again.
King one?
The Rock doesn't know.
No, thank fuck for that.
The Rock doesn't know you two. So help The Rock.
Tell The Rock exactly who in the blue hell are you two French popcorn farts anyway?
Who French popcorn farts?
It doesn't matter who you are!
So The Rock says he's gonna take a gold-plated shovel, and he's gonna hit the big slow right across his 59-pound head. Then he's gonna take The Undertaker with all his Mickey Mouse tattoos, bend him over, take one pile of dirt, pour it on top of his head, turn that shovel sideways, and stick it straight up his candy ass.
You actually think The Rock gives a monkey's nutsack what Pepe Le Pew number one and number two have to say?
Pepe Le Pew.
The Rock has something.
Oh, that. Wait. Can we just look at that fucking. That pet, you actually think .. The Rock gives a monkey's nutsack about what Pepular Pew number one Pepular Duh, of course it's Pepular.
The Rock has some video footage of the one thing you think you do best. So The Rock says, roll the footage.
What?
Come on then.
Oh boy. Big Show is livid.
Now, Big Show,
Big Show is never good at like a serious thing.
Let's look at it one more time from a different angle.
Uh-oh. He's poking at the big man.
Are you going to beat him French style? What the hell is that? What are you going to do? French kiss him to death? Is that what you're going to do? The Rock asked you one question. How's your lips? How's your lips? How do you like your lips? You like them where they are? Because if you keep running your mouth, The Rock and Mick Foley are going to slap your lips right off your French faces.
Yeah, you tell them.
Right here, flopping around like fish. And then, hold on a second. You're going to be like that. And what The Rock is going to do, The Rock and Mick Foley are going to pick up your French lips and make you kiss our American asses.
And The Rock's gift to you, Dean Malenko. The Rock is going to give you 6 inches. No. He's not going to give it to you there where you need it, so The Rock has heard.
But see, you two candy asses, you're not going to win the tag team titles. You know why?
I was watching, but nothing just went there. I don't know if you'd seen my screen or whatever. It went one ear out the other. Nothing. So, sorry, Rock, I think in the past 10 minutes, I've just grown immune to you, pal. You started to...
You're French.
Unless you throw the big game one, then I might have to chuckle, but an unnecessarily bad one.
You suck, exactly.
You, Perry Saturn, The Rock's gift to you. The Rock knows that you've got one eye that goes that way and another eye that goes that way.
In a minute.
And The Rock is just hoping for one single solitary second that the eye that's going that way is looking at The Rock's hand going that way, so The Rock will slap that crooked eye straight.
Thing would have happened. The French general would have walked right up to the enemy and would have said this. Oh, we are so sorry. We are so sorry. Oh, don't hurt us. No. We're so sorry. See, so you understand, the only thing strong about the French army is their damn body odor.
Oh, to you, Eddie Guerrero.
Was that meant to be a French accent? Can we... I feel like it is meant to be a French accent.
Oh, we are so sorry. We are so sorry. Oh, don't hurt us. No.
It doesn't matter what accent it is. It's just really bad.
The only thing strong about the French army is their damn body odor.
Oh, to you, Eddie Guerrero. The Rock's not got one, not two, but three gifts for you. The Rock's got a big sombrero. The Rock's got a donkey. And The Rock's got a nice hot bottle of tequila. So you can ride off in the sunset.
Tequila. Oh, for fuck's sake, aye. Thank you. Yes, no more Rock. Oh, that's sad. That. Know what? We'll find this fucking awful, awful video.
Soon after.
And then all of a sudden, you're doing jumping jacks. You're happy because Kane can talk. The big red... can finally
hey, at least I had the common sense to bleep it. Right, on On that note, that was your Try Not To Laugh, which weirdly had a lot of The Rock in it. I got fucking gammed out of that one. I apologise, everyone. If you didn't know what word he said the word...
I'm a lightweight, I am stuck in. Bottle of beer and I'm out my chicken.